Good morning, this is Jacob Allred with Novak Solutions. Today we're going to be talking about the Infusionsoft API and the Novak Solutions SDK. The API is an interface that allows you to connect third-party applications directly to your Infusionsoft app. For example, you can have your WordPress blog talk to Infusionsoft to add contacts or to pull contact information out. Infusionsoft provides a free SDK that allows you to use the API through PHP. Like I said, it's free. It's also powerful and has a fair amount of documentation, but it also has a few issues that developers sometimes encounter, such as blank responses from the API or error messages, and it has a bit of a learning curve that can make it difficult to get started with. At Novak Solutions, we've developed a new and improved SDK. It's also completely free. It's also powerful. And we're going to show you today how to use it to get contacts into Infusionsoft. Before we get started, though, I'd like to go over some of the benefits of the SDK. First of all, it doesn't have any dependencies other than PHP and curl, which most servers already have. It has code completion for IDEs like Eclipse and PHP Storm. It automatically retries API calls if they fail, and it's safe to retry it, such as a delete. So if you're trying to delete a contact and you get an error message back, our SDK will automatically try that delete again to make sure it went through. The SDK can automatically handle XML RPC, which is sort of the language that the API talks. Instead of having to form your own XML requests or decode them, the SDK will do that for you automatically. It also works around a few of the bugs the Infusionsoft API has, especially when it comes to international character sets. Saving records is easier in the Novak Solutions SDK. It will automatically pick whether to do an insert or an update based on whether you're working with a new or existing record, so you don't have to figure out which method to use on your own. We've also made the SDK future safe. If Infusionsoft decides to drop fields in the future like they have in the past, our SDK is just going to keep on working. You don't have to worry about it. So now that we've gone over some of the benefits, I want to show you an example of how to get a contact from code into Infusionsoft. To start, you'll need the SDK. We keep the latest version available at GitHub. That's at joeynovak/infusionsoft.php/SDK. This is the same service that a lot of major companies use to provide free code to the public. It makes it easy for us to collaborate with other people on the internet. For example, if you want to add your own feature to the SDK, you can do that, and then you can request us to merge it into our code so the whole community can benefit from your work. So to get started, we're going to grab the URL in the corner. This URL will let us copy the entire code onto our own computer. So we're going to go in here and git clone and then the URL to the repository. It takes just a moment for it to copy that to your computer. And it's already done. So we can come over here and see here's the SDK. There's a lot of different files related with it. I like to use NetBeans. I'm going to go ahead and pull up the SDK files in NetBeans, which is just an IDE. It's just a tool to make it easier to develop. So like I said, there's a lot of files related with the SDK. Luckily, you don't have to worry about almost any of them. You include one file, and it automatically pulls in the other files as needed in a very efficient way, so you don't have to worry about too much load on your server or using too much memory. So we're going to go ahead and create a new file. Let's call it new contact. And in this file, we're going to use the SDK to insert a contact into our Infusionsoft app. So before we get started here, we need to configure the SDK to be able to talk to our Infusionsoft app. To do that, we're going to find the config file, which is down here. We're going to copy the sample and put the sample into config.php. So we just copied the contents of config.sample.php and we're copying it into config.php. So there are two parts here we need to configure. The first is your Infusionsoft host. The Infusionsoft host is your full URL for your Infusionsoft app. So I have a sandbox app up here. The URL is az169.infusionsoft.com. I'm going to copy that over here. You also need your API key. To get your API key, go back to your app. You're going to go to admin settings. click on application on the left. If you scroll down to the bottom, the API key is your encrypted key. This is a very secret key. You don't want to give this to people that you don't trust. Anyone that has your encrypted key or your API key has access to everything in your Infusionsoft app except for credit card numbers. They can take all that information out. They can delete all that information. And if you're not running backups using a tool like our Infusionsoft backup tool, then you're not going to have any way to get that data back. If you don't see a key here, you'll need to enter in a passphrase. The API passphrase can be anything you want. It doesn't really matter. It's just used to generate the key. So I'm going to copy this key. I'm going to copy it into here and save. And there we go. That's all it takes to configure it. I have my host name. I have my API key. I can close this file. So now we have a blank file to get started with. The first step is to include the SDK into our script here. So to do that, we're going to require Infusionsoft PHP. So this includes the SDK. That one line of code makes all of the SDK available. It automatically pulls in the files that are needed. If you want to use contacts, it'll automatically pull in the contact PHP file. If you're looking to mess with tickets, it'll pull in the ticket PHP file. Everything's automatic. So for our example, we want to add a contact. So we're going to create a new contact object, which is Infusionsoft _ contact. Here's the code completion I was talking about. So what this does is it creates a new contact object that we can now add our information to and then save back into Infusionsoft. You could do something similar with any of the other tables that are in Infusionsoft, such as products or leads or invoices, all of these different things you could do just as easily by doing Infusionsoft _ the table you want to use. So we're going to do a contact. And then it's just very easy. It's just adding the information to the object and saving it back. Infusionsoft provides a documentation page that lets you know all the fields that are available. You can find a link to that underneath the video. So for our example, we want to add a first name. We'll call it Jacob. We'll want to add a last name, Allred. We can add an email address. Capitalized. And we can add other information too. I could add in my address. I could add in like lead source. All that information that you see in Infusionsoft can be added in here. And then to get that into Infusionsoft, we're going to call save. With our SDK, like I mentioned before, you don't have to know whether you're creating a new contact or updating an existing one. It automatically handles that for you to call the correct method. So save tells it to go ahead and put that information into Infusionsoft. We're going to save our file. And then we can go back to our command prompt. I'm going to use PHP to run the file. So PHP, we called it newcontact.php. The code's going to run. We can now go back to our application here, go to our contact list, and we can see here's the contact we just created. Pretty easy. Another great thing, we could also use it for custom fields. It takes a little bit more effort to do a custom field. Let me show you how to do that. So for my example, I have a custom field called favorite food. We're going to go ahead and figure out what that field's name is in the Infusionsoft database. We do that by going to admin settings. We go to our custom fields for contact. And it's going to have this link, view the field database names for the API. If you click that, it's going to pop up a window that shows all your custom fields, what kind of field it is, and what the database name is. I only have one because this is just a sandbox app. So the database name is favorite food with no spaces. When you're using the API, you need to add an _ in the front. So we're going to have _ favorite food. So if we go back to our code here, first we need to tell the SDK that the custom field exists. So we're going to say custom equals array. And this is just going to be an array of our custom fields. So favorite food. If I had another custom field called like hated foods, you could do that. You could add more than one field at a time. So we're gonna add favorite food. And then we have to use our contact object to add custom fields. And we're going to pass in this array we just created. If you're only doing a single field, you could just do it, add custom field, favorite foods. That might be a little bit easier if you're only doing a single field. I prefer to do the add custom fields because then you can easily go back and add another field later. All right, so we've added the custom field. The SDK now knows it exists. So let's do a new contact. Let's call it John Doe, john@novaksolutions.com. And we're going to add our favorite food. He likes pizza. So it's the same code as before. We've just added the custom field so that the SDK knows it exists. We've added the favorite food to the object. We're still doing save. Let's save this file. Let's run PHP new contact again. And this is just running this code. If you had this on a web server, you could call it through a URL on your web server. You could call it from a cron job if you're having something run on a schedule. There's a lot of different ways to call this file once you've created it. So we're gonna run that file. It takes just a moment to talk to the SDK, to the API for us. We go back to our app, go to contacts. We now have a second contact, John Doe. We can go over to our custom fields and we can see favorite food is pizza. So that's just a very basic example of how to get data inside of Infusionsoft from an external system. You can do a lot of powerful things with it. You can add tags automatically based on an action in another system. We use the API and our WordPress upsell plugin to make it very easy to make it so a customer can buy an additional product after they've just finished purchasing one. We use it, like I said, in all of our applications we do for our customers. So I hope you enjoyed this screencast. I hope it helped you get a little bit of a taste for what the API can do for you and helped you get a little bit of insight on how to get started. If you have any questions, feel free to post a comment or to email me directly, jacob@novaksolutions.com. I'm happy to help as much as I can. I hope you have a great day. Thanks.